the next thing that I got to do at this point is count how many wires and then figure out what I'm going to do with the connector.
I've counted 64 wires. So that's not including the alternator wire and the starter wire, just because those aren't going to go into the little connector that's going to go with that. I found one connector when I was looking. I found a 70-pin connector. So I'm going to order that one. I'm going to order the quick disconnects that I found for the other two wires. Haven't really found that people have used them in cars before, but I know they work really good and they can hold some amperage, so we'll find out. I'm going to go back under the dash and start working on that side because I don't want to cut anything on this side before I get the connector, because I'm going to forget by the time the connector shows up. Random disclaimer. So like 40 feet from... Well, less than 40 feet from my CRX is where all of our merchandise gets made by this beautiful lady here.
Hey, if you like the channel and you want to support us, we do have some new merch on the website, which is uwrenchaz.com. We still have the old school shirt and stuff like that, you know, just like that one or, you know, our other U-Wrench designs. But we've got some new stuff like blinker fluid with the ID10T part number, gone but not forgotten 10 mil, Valentine's Day with the Ugga Dugga. Got the heart on that. This one is actually for Fred. It's a toaster bath with an element. And then we have a few other ones, like, you know, ones for CRXs because I have a CRX and other things like that. But go check out the website. We have new merch coming. We're going to have new stuff coming out. These are just a sample of what's actually out on there. And yeah, we'd love you guys to wear our stuff.
If you guys want any shirts or cups or any of that stuff from us, she'll come out here while I'm wrenching on my car, or she'll stop working on her car and make you guys some merch. I am going to be showing you my laziness. I pretty much just got everything plugged in before, in the before time of me being stupid. So I just looked at it and I was like, well, do I really need to shorten all these wires, or can I just tape it up and nobody will ever see this? Well, now I'm showing everybody it. This, is pretty much the passenger side over. I did drop down some of this stuff. This is from the old engine harness, or the old ECU went up into, you know, Neverland up there. A lot of this stuff I'm still going to go through. This is all pretty much OE stuff. It is definitely time to go through this and make it right. This is going to be my main focus right now. I've got a get the fuse box sorted out with the other one that I have, and then I'm just going to go through and tidy up these. And for a lot of this stuff, like this one goes to the front of the car for the lights and whatnot on that side of the car. There might be some wires in here that I don't need anymore or that I'm not going to use, so I'll probably get rid of those and I'll probably just put a connector here. That way it's not a jumbled mess of taped together nonsense. Looking at some of this, we have a lot of wires that are just twisted throughout themselves. I'm not entirely sure how much of this I'm actually going to film, because this is the best part about wiring, which is trying to understand where it's going. And when it comes to aftermarket wiring, it makes it even more confusing. So trying to keep me sane and trying to make sure that I don't screw up any of the wires, I might not be filming a lot of this, but I'll show you what I figure out and I'll explain what I had to do to get it there. That way you actually understand a little bit of what's happening.
I'm going to show you what happens when you're doing stuff like this. So I've got a couple things sorted out. I've been de-pinning wires and rerouting them and then plugging them back in. And so I'm here at this connector starting to de-pin some of the mess that follows behind it. And while I was in here de-pinning it, I did a little more than de-pin. So now I'm going to stretch this pin open and try to re-crimp it, which I do have a crimper for it. But if I can't, then I've got to make a mental note and some pictures and stuff and make sure that this one goes right back into the exact same slot that it's supposed to be in. And I have to order a new pin, which, I mean, if I'm ordering one new pin, then probably going to order like 100 of them, because this might not be the only time this happens. Yeah.
I pulled off my fender here so that
I can go through the wires here and decide what needs to be out here, what needs to just go because I'm not using it anymore. And then I'm probably going to put it in a better spot. This is going to get rerouted probably up into the frame here. That way it's just protected from anything that the tire might throw at it. Stuff like this, I probably won't care to put back in. This was a side marker from my JDM days. I think some of these relays and like this grounding point here is probably going to just get moved into the car because it doesn't have to be out here. It can be grounded inside the car. I might just leave some wires up here to power lights. One of my goals with this car, at least my future, is endurance racing. And you're going to need some lights up front if you want to race when the sun goes down. Getting all of this stuff cut open, come to realize that I think all I'm really going to have coming down this side is going to be five wires. All of this will just essentially get either completely cut out of the harness or rerouted somewhere else that is better for it. Because I got to make notes of wire colors, because I'm actually going to order the wire colors that I actually need to keep this working, because I hate using just leftover scraps and getting a close enough color, so on and so forth. It would just be better to start anew, because actually these three, so they all have a white with green, but they are not white with green when they go into the connector.
You see, it can be done. Can be done.
Other than the headlights on the car, I'm probably going to add a light system whenever I get to the point of actually driving at night. So when I do that, I'll probably make that its sole little, you know, harness and unit and everything like that. So it'll have its own button and power source and so on and so forth. But the fun part is in here now. So I've pulled back wires, and this is one of the grounds that went to that ground piece up by the headlights. These, except for this one green with red tracer wire, all go to the driver's side of the car. So I'm guessing the fuse box or whatever's going on over there. This one green wire actually goes to this connector for the K-Series ECU. So I'm going to figure out, because I also figured out that the fuse box that I was going to put in here only has four actual fuses and then has eight relays. This fuse box is the alternator and other things. So I might be using this instead of that aftermarket one. That one might go for something else. All of these wires here are pretty much wires that I'm not going to be using. This one black wire went to that ground as well. I'm not sure why something on the driver's floorboard needed a ground wire over by the passenger headlight. I did have plans of making a panel here. I also gotta make this, which is gonna be my battery cutoff switch. That panel, I have all of these switches here. So I'm gonna mount these switches on that panel. If you really want to do a dedicated race car, you get rid of that, because randomly it can lock the steering wheel with all the bumps you do over a track. Getting rid of the entire lock mechanism for the key and everything like that is actually beneficial. It's a lot safer, just like getting rid of airbags on a racetrack. Having your airbags on a racetrack is also not beneficial. Most of this stuff like this, I don't need. I actually really hate that because I kick it every time I get out of the car. And if you ask why, this is why. This is almost as high as the bottom of the column. Get rid of my wipers. We don't need a four-way switch. I don't need a dimmer. Like I said, we're gonna put a different cluster in there. I'm wondering what the rest of my wires look like under there. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna pull the dash and commence the wiring. I also took off the front fender on this side because I really just need that one headlight, and there's another ground over there by where the headlight is, so we're gonna get rid of that too. Move that into the car. One big central ground location. And over by the headlights and whatnot are just gonna get their own individual grounds. This is what's left of that OEM fuse box. Bunch of random wires going to it. Bunch of random wires going up here.
speedo cable because it is an old car. So I'm going to go through all of this and we are going to see how much I'm keeping. I did get most of the wires out that I wanted to take out. Still a couple that I have questions on. I got to look up the schematics. Like, there's a ground that goes into the fuse box. So I got to make sure that that's a ground that either I need or I don't need before getting rid of it. I did take out some of the wires that went across to the other side. The washer or the wipers, that whole column is gone. Right now I have this one still in here. This is the headlights. That way I can keep them all in one area and then I'll probably put them to switches and then this will be gone. This is all of the stuff I've taken out so far. There is some wire loom in the trash right now, but these are all the wires and stuff in the loom that I took out right now.
I did say that I might not be using this, but I was thinking about it and I'll probably use this because I need relays for the fan, I need relays for the headlights, so on and so forth. So it'll probably be easier just to have them in this instead of trying to reuse some of the factory stuff. The other thing that I'm excited about is I got my wire harness connector for the engine. So it's got a little bolt on it and yeah, I'll have all of the little wires going through here. And then I have two connectors coming for the starter and the alternator wire that are different than this because this isn't meant for, what is that? I don't know, like 2 gauge, something like that. It might be 0, not exactly sure, but I did get something that works for essentially 4 to 0 gauge. And I think I got 6 to 4 for the alternator because I'm pretty sure that one's a 6. But that one, it's another quick disconnect. That way I can have all the wires all in one harness. I can just disconnect 3 connectors and then the engine is completely disconnected from the car, other than the chassis grounds that I'm going to put on it, which there's chassis grounds, engine, chassis, you're done. Thanks for watching. Check out the channel. Subscribe.